In this video, we continue with the topic of optimal photovoltaic and wind generator sizing. The main learning objective will fall under three main questions. First, what are the generator potential of solar and wind energy worldwide? Second, what are the sizing approaches for photovoltaics together with wind? And third, what is the optimal share of photovoltaics and wind in microgrids? As it is shown in the figure, solar irradiation has a high value over a year in many areas on Earth, such as Africa, Asia, South America, and also south of Europe, because we see changing photovoltaic insulation over a year. Even in Northern Europe, like the Netherlands, very little solar energy might be harvested during the winter, but a fairly acceptable level of solar energy is typically available during summer. In the figure, the solar irradiation is shown in the Netherlands through 1 year. January, day 0 and 365, has the lowest irradiance, while June and July have the highest one. If you look at the smooth average over the past 10 years, from 2001 to 2010, it is quite clear that there is a certain pattern which is a good starting point for sizing of photovoltaic generators. Similarly, we can show the availability of wind energy changing over the year across the globe. As it can be seen, the availability of wind energy is relatively high in the Northwest Europe, and in some countries there is high wind generation penetration, for instance, in Denmark up to 40%. Availability of wind energy is also high in the Netherlands. However, it is associated with the high uncertainty and intermittency. As it can be seen, the wind power can vary from zero up to the nominal power of wind turbine throughout the day, with a mean value of 0.187 of wind installed capacity. Data for wind energy over the years from 2001 to 2010 show that wind changes very often, and the average over the last 10 years is higher in winter and lower in the summer. Now, if you have a look at both solar and wind profiles, it seems they perfectly match each other. In other words, while wind has a concave shape, solar has a convex shape. Therefore, in any microgrid, the optimal size of photovoltaic solar and wind turbines for a long time period, like years, can be found in such a way that the average power output of these two units would be as smooth as possible. Nevertheless, it is worth to emphasize that within a short time like seconds, the mismatch between these two units would be high due to the high uncertainty and intermittency of both sources. In such cases, energy storage system, which we discussed before, seem viable option to smooth out the fast power variations of these two units. In this figure, we show the balance of the mix of energies between solar and wind based on show 10 years average, and some load pattern for the microgrid, which is a standard Dutch load pattern. On the left-hand side of the figure, there is 100% of wind, while on the right-hand side, 100% of solar energy. Different scenarios for 40% penetration of energies from solar and wind up to 100% is calculated. Particularly for these calculations, the battery capacity was used for only 1 day, which means 24 hours. This graph is showing that there is always an optimum point for which photovoltaic solar energy matches wind. If the fraction of renewable energy is higher than 40% and we have only storage for 24 hours, we have to waste energy or put it back in the grid, and it cannot be used in the microgrid itself. The storage might have to be oversized in case of 2 or 3 days in a row with no solar, no wind, and then we get a different results, of course, and different graphs. With increasing the fraction of renewable energies in the system, there are different optimum points for percentage of wind and solar in the system. To cope with the demand and make a 100% renewable energy microgrid, we have to oversize solar and wind by around 25%. There still remains few days per year without wind and solar, so without seasonal storage, the system cannot be reliable. In this video, we first address the matching opportunities for photovoltaic solar and wind production through a year according to the historical data. Remember, there still remain few days per year without with no wind and solar, so without seasonal storage, the system cannot be reliable.